other night I was in a rather emotional conversation with another person, and we were reviewing some of the failures and roadblocks and obstacles and tough stuff of the past and even present. And as we proceeded in this kind of interaction, I felt I had to stop. And I said, "Hey, hold on just a minute. You know, I think that you and I are speaking as if God did not even exist. As if we're in this whole thing alone and there were no options. That's bogus. Let's start over, okay?" Welcome to Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce. If you've been with us before, welcome back. And perhaps tonight we're touching some new listeners who are wondering what kind of music this is and who is this guy. The name is Bill Pearce, and we've been on the air for quite a number of years with the program Night Sounds. And even though we've heard this particular theme music thousands and thousands of times, there's something refreshingly new about this whole scene. Because even though we are welcoming back those of you who've been with us before, I'm touching new listeners right now. And that's quietly exciting because we're not exactly certain what's going to happen here. This is sort of an open-ended type of format. There is no script, but we do select certain directions and titles to our moments together. And tonight, I've decided to borrow a title that I saw in a book called God Confidence. This is possible. And I hope and pray that before our time together tonight is concluded, that you will recognize a brand new power source, if you have not before. God is here, and He's there, and He's where He is welcomed. And that's why this first song was written, recorded by the Imperials Quartet. I look for excuses and reasons to play this because I love this particular song and its direction of lyrics. So if you're sort of insecure tonight, take a listen to this.
Tomorrow brings us isn't certain anymore. So many paths from which to choose, don't know which way to run. 'Cause every road leads nowhere, every road except for
I
Imperial's Quartet, talking about God. As the scriptures say, in whom there is no variance, neither shadow caused by turning. In other words, he's the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow, and that is liberating. And that is the platform tonight that we're joining together in. In fact, there's a scripture verse, and I'm taking some of my commentary tonight from the book entitled Walking in Total God Confidence by Donna Parto. And she said, I want to share with you one of my favorite verses in the Bible. 1 John, in the New Testament, chapter 3, verse 1, which reads, How great is the love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. That last sentence is our jumping-off place. This is the platform in tonight's program. And she said, You may not know this, but there are certain verses in the Bible that only work if you read them with an attitude. Okay, I want you to stand up. Come on, everybody on their feet. Read through this verse again, but this time, read it aloud. 1 John Chapter 3, verse 1. When you get to the part that says, And that is what we are, I want you to put your hands on your hips and say it with an attitude. I mean, don't even mess with me attitude. We have to do this sometimes in person. It's lots more fun. Let's think about it. The implications of this verse. If God is the King, and we are His sons and daughters, what does that make us? Maybe you'd say a princess or a prince. But even though that may be true, this is no ordinary condition. A prince or princess. A princess with an attitude. PWA. This isn't a side benefit. Ephesians 1, verses 4 through 6, tells us that bestowing the princess or prince title upon us was God's plan from the very beginning. In love, He predestined us to be adopted as His kids through Jesus Christ. And that is a neat plan. In accordance with His pleasure and will, to the praise of His glorious grace, which He has freely given in the one He loves. Tonight's program, God Confidence. Donna Parto said in her book, I'll never forget speaking at a retreat where the average attendee was about 70 years. The oldest was in her 90s. It was a little awkward the first night because it was pretty obvious that I was just a fraction of their age. I challenged them to consider that, and that maybe, just maybe, God was big enough to work through a young, slightly wacko vessel. Well, they were a bit skeptical, but once we got into the PWA part, we bonded. Hey, a princess is a princess, regardless of her age. And that night, a group of ladies broke into the camp kitchen and raided the aluminum foil. I thought I'd die when they showed me the next morning in the front. They were there, sitting with their aluminum foil tiaras on their heads. Now that's the kind of princess I want to be as I approach my centennial. Those of you with teenagers probably have heard the expression, talk to the hand. They put their hand right in front of your face when they say it. It means there's nothing negative you've got to say to me that I'm going to hear. Well, when the enemy comes against us, we need to say this. Talk to the hand. Don't even mess with me, because I am a prince. I am a princess. Talk to the nail-scarred hand, the hand that bled to earn for me the right to be called a child of God. Tonight's program, God Confidence. God is still there, even though, as I mentioned a few moments ago, we speak and we act and we feel and conclude things as if he did not exist, that he wasn't even interested, that he wasn't even within calling distance, which is a bogus attitude. So tonight, as we meet together, let's do it with confidence. Tonight, I do not have a whole lot of confidence in myself, and maybe it's good that the Lord put this on my heart to speak to, because that's good to be reminded, and all I'm doing is reminding you that we are something very special in God's eyes, because he sees us not as failures, not as handicapped, not as anything, but his loved ones. He sees us with the eyes of grace, and that's something else. So if anything tonight, we want to be in an up position, because once again, we are something special that even the angels of heaven don't know anything about. They probably look at us with curiosity. Hey, what did Joe or Susie do down there to deserve that? We don't even have that. That the Prince of Peace, the God of creation, should enter this human scene with all of its filth and who knows what all, to be treated like a common criminal because of the greatest and most unconditional love ever considered. And as we meet together tonight, I certainly am not a cheerleader type, but there are those moments when we can become excited, even incredulous that God would do this. I found myself praying the other day, do you really love me? He should say that to me because I'm the one on the lesser end here. Of course he loves you, or he wouldn't have done what he did. And that's why we're here tonight, to share that love and let you know that you're not only special, you are totally privileged. You have a legacy that's incredible, and so do I. God has not changed. And again, the scriptures say he is without variableness, neither shadow caused by turning. The same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And that sameness is not a ho-hum attitude, what's new. It's something thrilling, because we can come to him as we are, time and time again, with something we don't deserve, and that is grace, unmerited favor. But he's there. In fact, I'm going to ask Kim Hall to sing about it right now. A song of prayer. Oh God, you are still there. You're still holy. Praise God.
Holy, you are still holy, even when the darkness surrounds my life. Sovereign, you are still sovereign, that's kept me from your touch. I want my life to be a pure reflection of your love. And so when my unbelief has kept me from your truth. I want my life to be a sweet devotion to you. I belong to you, and so I come into your chamber, and I dance at your feet, Lord. You are my Savior, and I'm at your mercy. All that has been in my life up till now, it belongs. I belong to you. You are still holy. You are still sovereign. You are still holy, Lord. You are still righteous.
Soloist Kim Hill, reminding God of what he is as if he needs reminding. But you know, we get into these kinds of moods sometimes that are negative and dark and condemning, and we really need help, and God is there. And it's good to be reminded, isn't it, that we are not alone, that we're not working through this thing with no options, with nobody anywhere. I felt that way. In fact, I think it was this morning. I started the day in prayer because I awoke with that kind of a mood. This is Night Sounds, in case you've just joined us. Thank you for coming our way. Hope this will become a habit with you. It is with me. I'm here regardless. Thank the Lord. Many of you write to us after we go off the air. We find that the Night Sounds ministry continues. There are certain points of time that we come to where we need a certain kind of factor for confidence, spiritually, emotionally, physically. And I have to remind myself, too, that God is here, no matter how I feel. We pray for one another here. And if we can join you in prayer for any concern, please allow us this privilege. If you'd like a catalog of the further expressions of Night Sounds, our mailing address is Box 29, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. I'm constantly being sent booklets through the mail. Here's one that was an interesting title. It reads, 101 Things God Cannot Do. Number one, He can't lie. Hebrews 6:18 backs this up with these words, that by two immutable things, in which it was impossible for God to lie, we might have a strong consolation, who have fled for refuge to lay hold of the hope set before us. Another thing God cannot do, He can't be given a problem that He can't solve. Validated by Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. But Jesus beheld them, and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. This is the kind of information we need to hear and transfer.
If I could find the right words to say, to tell you just what Christ means to me, I'd say He's more than I could show, and more than you'll ever know. If you could have seen just yesterday, you'd know why He's life and breath to me. You'd know why He's more than I could show, and more than you'll ever know. Christ means more to me than you'll ever know. Christ means more to me than I could possibly show.
So much we don't know, so much we've got to learn yet. I've often mentioned this, but it just came to my mind again. My mother said to me one time at 93 years of age, Billy, God showed me that I've got so much to learn yet. Well, 96 or 6, we have a lot to learn. Doesn't matter what kinds of sheepskin or trophies we might have on the wall of our offices. We haven't even begun, but God is ready if we are. May we turn to Him. Let's remember tonight that God does have a unique call upon the life of anyone, everyone He redeems. And if he has redeemed you and you've asked him into your life, he will lead you. We can often discover our unique race by getting back in touch with the childhood dreams or the noble ambitions that we had as even new believers in Jesus Christ. Let's review. We don't look back to review the past in a negative way. We sort of recall to see what we've learned or to be reminded of some of the wonderful things God has in store for each one of us. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for tonight's program. Thank you for your uniqueness. Thank you that you have made us special people because we belong to you. We're family. And I just pray for that one who does not particularly understand or feel that he or she would be family with you. Touch their hearts and spirits as they reach out to you in faith and in their desperate need. In Jesus' name, who made it possible. Amen. Well, thank you for being a special person tonight, for many reasons, not the least of which is that you are a listener to Night Sounds, and that we've asked God to touch our hearts. In case we could get hold of you, or vice versa, if we can answer any questions, send a catalog of the various unique and adjacent ministries of this outreach, our mailing address remains Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Let's go through the night and tomorrow in confidence in Him. Till we meet again, a great day and a peaceful and restful. Good night to all of you.